About the knees, here we go, dem knees. The greatest cause of visits to the GP for musculoskeletal problems, problem knees. And again, like the other parts of the body, a lot to do with muscle dysfunction. In this instance, in a different way, with the muscles of the thigh getting weaker, the quadriceps, more than anything else. And you'll see the main problem predisposing to trouble with the knees is alignment of the legs. So let me go on to explain. By and large, the knee develops two types of problems. And again, with cartilage, two types of cartilage problem. So again, let me clarify. There is the menisci, or the knee cartilages, which are different. They are fibroelastic cartilage, which is different to the general buffer of cartilage here that protects all synovial joints. So this is called hyaline cartilage, this is called fibroelastic cartilage. These tend to be more injured with traumatic sporting stuff, but they too can break down and lead to erosion through to the bone and lead to problems in that regard. However, having said that, by far the most common problems with knees is not cartilage at all, either of those two varieties of cartilage. It is patella, and here it is. The patella grows in the quadriceps tendon. Its role is to be like a friction defraying device, preventing rub of this cartilage around the front of the femur bone there, like fraying rope through a pulley. And you can see that the role of the patella here is very interesting, and I go into this in much more detail in my knee arthritis prevention video. This is a bag of fluid in the knee joint which actually helps stop the bones grinding here. And what's very important is strength of your quadriceps muscle pushing in here to pressurize this sac, this hydraulic sac, to actually spring the knee joint apart to prevent the bones rubbing. Now, the patella here, it's very important that the underside of that patella is lovely and smooth and sort of plastic compliance, shiny, to prevent any type of drag of the contact between here and here through this sac of fluid. Sounds complicated? It really isn't. It's a beautiful mechanism. But we start getting problems when the knee isn't quite straight. We see it both with the knee not actually straightening properly from being bent in a forward back direction. And this is very common if the leg is longer. What tends to happen with a longer leg is that we imperceptibly stand with the knee of that leg slightly bent to take some length out of it. That adds to the general resting friction of the back of the kneecap against the front of the femur bone. The other way we have alignment problems is being bow-legged or knock-kneed, so that the kneecap has to literally track around a corner as it slides up and down as you bend and straighten the knee. And that is the main cause of knee problems. So that you get this friction here. So this is the underside of a smooth patella, absolutely glassy, lovely compliance about the plastic compliance of a washing up bowl, but also this lovely element of slipperiness too, and smooth. This is what happens if you get too much friction. You get what we call chondromalacia patellae. It's like a splintery board. Very common pain going up and down steps, down primarily, but you'll see in the exercises to follow, very disarmingly simple exercises to follow to help polish this off. And here we go.